And to the RST Corporation, terraforming specialists, RST turned the environment against the Vec and nearly destroyed the island in the process. Well, that's unfortunate. Oh, it tells us what Vec can appear there. My advisors insist we're losing the fight. They also insist I trust you. And since those cowards rarely insist I do anything, I'm giving you a chance to prove yourselves. So, Rust District will give us a power to protect the power generator and has a volatile Vec. We do not like volatile Vec. They're annoying to not kill. Doomsday Point. High threat detected. Defend the train and protect the coal plant. Can we deal with a high threat? Either of them will give us access to two spots. This one has reactor core. I'm gonna get one power. That's better for getting more power in our power group, which is really what we need right now. So I'm just gonna do it. We'll see. The maglev runs the soul power. We need to get out of the approaching storm front before its cells die. It's already a scarab and three more coming up at the start. So we'll be dealing with four enemies right away. Oh wait. We need to equip our weapons. Your front class weapon. What do you mean open another breach? Well, okay. And you have the face cannon, which we're going to use instead of that. Right, before we go there, let's do it. Does face are only one object or multiple objects? I don't know. What have we got? We got Scion, which flies, so we can't chuck it in the water. 2 hit points. All other Vec receive 1 hit point as long as living, so we want to kill it quickly. We have Scarab, Alpha Scarab. Oh, maybe that's where it's high threat. He's got 5 hit points, or 4+1 right now. Does 3 damage, so we do not want to get hit by him or let anything get hit by him. He's on sand. The tile will turn into smoke when damage, preventing this unit from attacking. Oh, is that what sand is about? So that's sand. Dunes, okay. And we have 2 ordinary fireflies that are being buffed by the sound. And we have this train. Supply train has 1 fucking hit point. Oh dear, 1 hit point. It moves to. Can't be summoned fire, unaffected by smoke, can't be pushed. It'll be this. Destroyed if blocked. This is always moved. We just have to keep it clear. And keep it from being attacked. Okay. Which means we can't go there. We'll move you here so you can move up and punch, maybe. I don't know, we'll see. Not sure the shooting through things is necessarily useful this turn. We'll see how we get on. Now we'll move you there instead so you have some ability to come up here if we need it. Let's see what happens. 4 turns, so that's quicker than usual, because it'll go 1, 2, 3, and then victory, I guess. So we need to make sure the train's not blocked and it's not attacked. Alright, so right now, he doesn't attack. Alpha Scarab does 3 damage. Now this is nice, we can punch him to here, where he'll attack the Siren and kill it for us. I like the sound of that a lot. So that means already in one move, we got the blockage out of the way of the train, got the attack. Oh, we'll do 3 damage. Oh. We're not going to kill the train if we light it on fire. Can we change our weapon? Right click or Q to disarm, what does that mean? Oh, okay, that's just... cancels the attack. It's a train. Supply train. Oh, it's immune to fire. Cool. So setting it on fire is not a problem. Bang. Train is no longer under threat this turn. Alpha Scarab. Did not take damage. Why not? Oh, it only damages units that are already on fire. Oh, that's not what I thought. Alright, well, it'll kill the Scion next turn. Train moves last of all. You want to attack the coal plant, which we don't like. So we only need to push you this way. Which I could do. No, I can't, because you're in the way. What I could do, I push you onto the tile, you'll take two damage, one from the attack, one from the tile. Then we'll still be taking that damage. Wait, so he pushes you, you'll each take one. Then I can shoot you for another one. If I have to take the damage either way... doesn't matter where I'm taking it from. In fact, the artillery's probably better at taking it. Oh, I can actually push you to the water. Yeah, you're not attacking. So I attack you for one. Push you for one. Good. That gives me more movement options next turn, I guess. Yeah. So, okay. So I can't phase through tie buildings. Great. But we'll just shove me in the water for now. Oh, did you level up again? Max level there. Alright. Bang! They get their buff is lost. And what are they doing? Extra scarab or alpha scarab? I don't know. Oh! What the hell is that thing? Firefly is going to attack our tank or a building. We don't want you to attack buildings. Train is clear. That's the Alpha Scarab, which is going to attack a building, which we don't want. So we really want to shove it onto this tile. Okay. That's an ordinary Scarab, which is no threat if we move our Punch Man. It's an Alpha Blobber. Throw a massive blob that will explode, doing 3 damage all around it, including to the train. Dear, oh dear. Explodes, killing itself and damaging. Kill it first to stop it. So we need to kill the blob. Absolutely need to kill that blob. We want to kill Blobber if we can, which we could push into the water, but we're artillerying that spot, which is going only going to be possible from here. Here or there, so we can do that. You can punch the blob to kill it, you can. Then you can't move. Oh, wait. Oh, the train moves last. So that attack. Oh, that's crossing the train. If we push you there, that's fine. Yeah, that's actually good. You'll take damage, stop an enemy. How do we deal with you? inner tank. I assume the utility is going to do that. Question is, does it do it before or after he gets shunted out of the way? You can take damage. The building preferably can't, so I want to shunt you to there, shunt you into him. Right, so you're first. Bang. Right, building is safe. Third building is safe, you'll take one hit. Artillery there. Let's punch him while we can. Fire damage should happen first, so hopefully that will do the job. I keep forgetting it's not a proper punch. And artillery, the train cannot be moved. I guess that's what the shield means. Yeah, stable, cannot be moved by any weapon effect. And we should hopefully drown that Alpha Blobber, because it doesn't say it's massive. And hurt the Scarab, which will still attack us. Okay, not bad. He'll die because he's on fire. Great, you won't, but should be easy enough to kill next turn. You should die because you're on fire. Which leaves us with three enemies next turn. Dead. Dead. Oh, four enemies. Ouch. Ouch. Train moves. Two new enemies come up. We have another Firefly and a... what's that one called? Let's find out. Alright, so they want to attack the train, so we need to deal with that. That's a Hornet. It flies, does one damage adjacent, okay? So if we just get you guys out of the way, you're a problem. Units of smoke cannot attack or repair. Shove into smoke, you'll be fine. Building under threat. Movement is problematic. If I shoot the Hornet, it will die. Take one damage from the shot, one from being pushed into the Firefly, and the Firefly will take one damage. Well, that's a good move for him, but what about this one, which is... and we could tank it, but I don't really like that idea. We can punch you or something to get you out of the way. If your attack happens first, we can artillery this spot, or that spot, to push you. Push you onto that corner, you'll be closer to going in the water. And you will attack before the train moves, so you'll attack empty space, and the train will move through it. Oh wait, you'll actually attack our tank, but we'll win in one turn. So attacking our tank is fine. Right, one dead. I think you need to go punch him. Or set it on fire. Well, push it into the water, yeah. And you need to artillery that smoky spot for the other spot, which will push into the fire so it can't attack into the smoke. I think that's the way it works, right? Use the smoke, cannot attack or repair. So it applies to enemies as well. Presumably. I hope. I'm going to be annoyed if not. That way I won't take the damage. Oh, that's no good, because I'll push myself in the way of the train. Unblock the train. So yeah, let's go with our original plan. We'll tank the damage, it's fine. Right, let's do it. Perfect victory, nothing was damaged. At least, nothing that we needed the power lost. And we got an extra power and 2 rep. That's very good. That's a lot better than I expected. And we gotta level up. Both barrels. No. The boom leveled up. Got an extra move. What did you do that last time? Oh, that's good. We have no more cores, so we can't do any more use upgrades or anything. So, do I want the flamethrower? Or the fist? I think. I think I want the fist. Does 2 damage, or is that. I didn't realize when it says damage 2 that it's only does damage. Only damages units already on fire. It just says damages are only fire, which I thought was bonus damage, but no. It only damages units on fire with 2. So it's 2 turns to. Which is bad. I'd rather do 2 damage and a push than no damage and merely set off fire. Because sitting on fire doesn't stop enemies moving or attacking or anything like that. It just. It's occasionally useful, but seems more situational than a punch every time. Phase cannon seems like a free upgrade. Like, we haven't managed to get extra power, so it's absolutely better right now. So we'll keep that. And you don't have any other options except more health, which I'm going to keep going for health. Detonation Park. End the battle with less than 4 mech damage. Protect the emergency batteries. Warning cataclysm. I suppose that is going to damage us. I know. Nice. Hardened point. Kill at least 7 enemies, and which is always tough, and protect the coal plant. What does it look like? Oh, I see. We kill them by knocking them in the water, I guess? And they're flying. How do we kill them? Knock them over the abyss, presumably. Detonation Park. Just the name sounds fun. The map will gradually break apart into a massive chasm. Try not to fall in. Yeah, I like the sound of this one. I like the sound of this. The cataclysmic failure of the terraforming in the region is destroying the land. Try not to fall into the depths. Let's do it. Quaterns. Protect the emergency batteries, which is right near the baddies. Okay, we've got 2 scarabs and an alpha hornet, which has 4 hit points, does 2 damage, and stabs 2 tiles in front of it. And it won't fall into the depths, I guess? That's the chasm. Oh, that's the chasm will happen there. So we just need to keep him on that edge of the map. That sounds reasonable. Yeah? Stabby McStab face, I mean punching punch face, and both barrels, and well. Yeah, we want the ability to move a bit, so let's just do that. Let's go! Oh, cataclysm happens immediately, okay. Alright, so we want the scarab in the water, I think. We want to punch you into the rift, which will happen first anyway, so you can attack. If I move back and push you, if I use the artillery to push the scarab, which kills it, because that way I can do damage with the cannon. What's this phase through objects? Does that include my units? It does include my units. So I can just move up there and shoot. Do 1 damage, knock you back onto the next, which should do another damage, and you're in line going to the cataclysm. Or I can punch you. And then shoot you. You will be in the cataclysm. You will die. That means one of the buildings will die. We need to stop both scarabs. I think causing you to take 2 damage is not bad. It's not bad at all. You go there and punch him into the rift. Wait. The artillery can punch you into the rift. There's 2 new guys coming up here. Artillery's strong, so front lines. Yeah, let's do it that way. That way you'll have better access to punch them. Oh no. Can't artillery next to me. I'm doing my move. Fuck. Didn't work out the way I want, but we'll do it. Okay, so we'll get 2 new enemies next turn. You'll take 1 more damage. And you'll throw up some smoke. And you'll die. Slam it first. You'll attack nothing. You'll get damaged. Let's do it. Lands are falling away. Okay, I've got bonuses now. And they're flying. At least they're all bunched up, so maybe we can use that. Nobody's gonna fall over the rift this turn, unfortunately. You're just an ordinary hornet. So artillerying that spot would be kind of nice. You take 1 damage. Punch them over there. Punch them to there. That would leave us with 2 more attacks. Can't punch you. We can cannon you through the building. But that'd have to be from the same spot. Although we could absolutely from there. And push you into ourselves and take some damage. Well, it doesn't mean you'd take damage. But it does mean you would not be out of the way of the building. We need to protect the building. We could just kill it. Let the building take damage, but we don't. We're trying to avoid any building damage if we can. Cannon you for 1, knock you into that for another 1. Get you to kill that one by punching you that way. Let's try that. You're only attack adjacent. Let's try that. Fire through the buildings. Okay. If I punch you onto it, it'll die and you'll be on that spot, right? I think. Well, if not, then we have the artillery to fix up the whatever. Oh no, we should kill them both. Excellent. Artillery cannot attack that one this turn, and it's flying, so we can go over water. We could. No, we can't get into. Oh, we could get into a position to punch it onto there, but it's. Which will kill it. We'd only be up there. A long way away from anywhere, But we have 4 movement points, and there's baddies coming up there, and there's places. Not very many places to move. Seems like a bad option. Alternatively, we just shunt it into the water. Or we can create more sand and more smoke. Seems a little pointless. I think I want the movement options for now. It's not going to attack anything, so we can let it go. We do not have to kill a certain number of enemies, so it's obviously better if we do. So let's do it. Let's constrain their movement options. It's flying now, so it's not going to be damaged. Alpha Firefly. Well, I mean, it's going to die before it can attack, so it's a bit daft. The Hornet is kind of nuisance, but we can shoot it to put to move it away. Phase through everything. Yeah, so your Alpha Firefly is just going to die. That's, like, ridiculous. I can move here, shoot through it. Oh no, we can't shoot through you. I need to punch you to death. Or artillery you to death. Wait. We won't actually kill that one. Well, we could. Punch you to death. Artillery you to death. Artillery you once. Then shoot you to death with the cannon. Sure, why not? 2 hit points now. Artillery, one. Hello? And you will die to the cataclysm. Boom. Region secured. We got the bonus power, which is great. We're almost at the top. And we got the rep as well, which is nice, but less important. And we got a promotion. Got an extra move. I wanted extra health, but I will take extra move for early. So movement is 4. That's not bad. We got hardened points. Kill at least 7 enemies and destroy the coal plant, and strange back activity. Flying back are emerging from underground hives beneath the island through erosion points. Oh, they'll be coming up through the hole. And we're gonna kill at least 7. That's hard, we don't really do enough damage. Restricted area. Defend both solar farms. Probably not so bad. That gives us 2 power. One will increase, the other will increase our base defense. Sure. Why not? Fist of Doom. So, cannon can stay all the way back here because they can phase through stuff, so that actually gives it plenty of options. Artillery, well, cannon and artillery kind of up there, but we'll see. Might do better off down here. You got 4 movement, so if I put you there, you've got plenty of options. And if I put You there, you've also got plenty of options. Put you there. I mean, artillery's tankier. Of course. 5 turns. Let's see what happens. I'll just keep them from getting up near the solar farm right now. The artillery are going to be the problems. Alright, they can be moved about. So, 2 scarabs, 2 hit points each. We can go punch them. Punch one into the other if we want. We can nullify the hornet by just artillerying its spot. I think we do more than that. Can we kill? Oh, we could kill it this turn, so we got 2 hit points. But we need to kill both the artillery because they're more of a threat generally. No really great. We can artillery you and hit you for 1. Push you harmlessly out of the way. Punch you, shoot you. That keeps the artillery out of the way. Alternatively, we can kill both artillery. I think the artillery, because they stay back, are going to give us more movement options. So I think I'd rather punch you. Oh, that's actually stopped its attack, so... Well, I can kill it either way, but... I can kill it from there, which is probably worth... Missed! Firefly and a... blobby thing. Is that an alpha blob? Alpha blobber? Right! You're a nuisance. You're a nuisance. You're a big nuisance, but you're not attacking. You're a problem. Alpha Firefly does 3 damage. Yikes. You're kind of stuck at the moment. So, we can only punch the goo or artillery it out of the way. We can artillery it to there, which gets your damage to your own silly self. And it will kill itself. That's kind of okay. Unless I got a better move for the artillery. I can shoot you into the smoke. To stop your attack. Okay. It's not a bad idea. I can... That's the only reason anyone can do anything about that, and that's only by firing on there or there, which is kind of not great. I can punch you to death, that's fine. You're going to be a nuisance unless I kill you every turn, so I really want to punch you onto there to kill you this turn. Can I risk taking 1 damage on a building? Two alphas is not great. We can have a bunch more enemies next turn, so stopping an enemy is also good. I can shoot myself. Negate his damage, push him into the crowd. Or get out, if I can get out first. Then I can shoot that. Punch you into there. Okay, you don't stop the enemy coming up, but I'm out of the way. And freed up my cannon. Cannon has 4 movement. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, you can move there and shoot that. That's fine. I can artillery there and get pushed. Doesn't matter the order of that. Scarab won't be dead, but will be out of the way. You'll be dead. You'll be... I can have 5 enemies to deal with. Oh dear. Take 1 damage to the alpha and knock me into the cloud. I think that's the right move. Oh, I killed it right away. Oh yeah. So now I'm gonna go there and just destroy that. Blobs go on. And you're not doing damage, but the attack is cancelled, so. Ah, balls. No, I did that wrong. In the wrong order. Well, I definitely did that wrong. Whatever. Ouch. Deal. Okay, hornets and a thing that's boosting us. Right, just all attack our mechs, I'm happy. Right. 2 turns remaining. Alright, you can move, but not very far. Kinda wanna kill you. Kinda wanna kill you. You do 3 damage, so I can move you there. And you will do 3 damage to the next. Oh, I need the next tile. You do 1 damage. But you can kill that one, right? I can punch you that way. Or shoot you that way. I can shoot you into them. Shoot you into them, freeing up space for my puncher. What am I going to do about the scarab? These two to neutralize. So you're no threat. If I can get. Well, neither of you are a threat, so if I'm out of the way. So I actually need to kill you guys. Killing that will make those only 2, which is nice. I shoot it into there, which will do 1 damage to you, 2 to you, and you'll be on 1 hit point. Or ditto that way, but that's more of a threat. But that means then you'll get hit, which I don't want. You can tank it. Artillery the tile in order to get the scarab out of the way. Which is 2 attacks to neutralize. Shoot you, move up there and punch you. You do 3 damage, that's no good. I don't want to take 3 damage because I'll die. You do 1 damage, you do 1 damage. I'm just gonna risk 1 damage to a building at this point. Alright, so everybody's reduced. That'll get killed next turn. I can kill one of those two. And the other's going to take their attack. Let's kill the one I can kill. And the attack is resisted. Nope. Battle lost 100 casualties. Okay, now the Firefly. Right. So attacking us, not the buildings, so we can kill the Scarab or shunt out of the way. Let's shove these into each other! Yes! I bet they didn't see that coming at all. And let's just harmlessly move this Scarab out of the way. Fortunately, we didn't kill it, but we've completed our objective. We'll get our 2 power back. So no bonus power, but the one we lost is recovered. Both solar farms protected. Alright, I think we get one more attack before the one more mission before the corporate HQ. Erosion flats, high threat detected. Defend the prototype Renfield bombs and protect the robotics lab. Alone Messer, defensive shields, defend the Earth Mover. Hardened point, killing 7 enemies is tough. Volatile death for pain. Power's in a decent state to find out what this is all about. And the extra core would be very useful. Just get extra power in MX. So let's try it, we'll probably fail. 2 warheads. To protect, okay. 2 spots to defend, that's fine. And, well, 3 spots, there's robotics lab and bombs. The site holds 2 warheads designed by a temporal physicist, Dr. Renfield, utilizing your breach technology. RSC was deemed the safest place to test them. Let's do it. So high threat because we've got big enemies. We've got an alpha blobber. To begin with, we have a Soldier Scion. Both of those we want them to die as soon as possible. Ordinary Scarab and Ordinary Hornet. Prototype Bomb! Cannot be set on fire, explodes on death, dealing 1 damage to adjacent tiles, but we want to protect it, obviously. Yeah, that's not what we wanted. Alright, let's find out what you are. Robotics Lab, just a building to defend. Alright, where do we want to deploy? Punch! Movement in 2 axes, movement. Around the place, let's try that. See what happens. Oh, there's a pod. Let's hope they don't move onto it, because the blob in the worst possible place. Alright. Everything threatened. So. Hornet's threatening building. Okay, fine. You're threatening an empty spot. That's cool. You're not threatening. You're not threatening right now. You need to die. It's an alpha blob. But it's got 1 hit point, so we can kill it easily enough. I can move here and punch that into that, killing that one, damaging that one. Or do we kill the Alpha Blobber? I can shoot it into that one as well. One attack is needed. One attack is needed to destroy the alpha blob. One attack should be done on that to stop the building the attack. And beyond that, we're free. Pod, save the building. I'm gonna punch the alpha blobber, so it'll take 3 damage. And now I'm gonna shoot the blob. Oh shite. Oh dear. I didn't realize they moved. I think it's time for the... That was a really bad move, because we took damage, tons of damage, and lots of objective. Let's start the turn again. We're gonna do it once a battle, but I think this is the move to start it again. Alright. A localized time breach. Let's start the same way, because I think that's the right move there. Now, if you can explode safely, if we just shunt you out of the way, you'll explode safely. Which means firing our artillery there or there. Well, there. Push you, that's no problem. In fact, what attack is it? You'll get killed before you explode even. So let's do that. Let's just change our artillery move. Artillery's up there. Yeah. That's a lot safer. So, Alpha Blob will do nothing because it's not attacking. The Cyan will do nothing because it's not attacking. The Scarab will destroy the Blob. And the Hornet will attack an empty spot. Unknown. The Blob will take another damage. We'll get up another blob next turn, but hopefully that'll be it. Let's see what happens. Interesting to note that I can push the bombs around. If I need to. Alright, 2 bombs threatened. Two buildings threatened. This isn't looking great. Of course, I'm moving my artillery out of the way, and artillery that spot. That bomb is moved to safety, but not that one. If I destroy the blob and artillery this, and move my puncher and artillery in. The bomb's gonna be moved out of the way and be safer. I can destroy the blob. That leaves the buildings under attack there, which I don't really like, because I'm not getting bonus power and we're getting to have 2 power there, but I could punch one into the other. Kill one, hurt the other, but not kill it. Let's save one. You've got 4 movement. You can get up there if the artillery's out of the way. We're gonna end up with another blob next turn. We've got too many turns and not enough. Too many turns and not enough stuff happening. If I destroy the Scion. Blob not getting banished from the Scion. If I destroy the Scion, then they're only one, they're only two. The Blob needs to die first, and it's only one. There's no combinations here where this makes sense. I can punch that one, shoot that one, or artillery yet. I can't artillery yet. But I can if I punch that. It'll destroy the bomb. I can shoot it. I can sit on there, stop an enemy coming up. That leaves a free artillery move. Hit one of these and save one building. No, you're gonna find off another blob first. You need to die. And punching is the only way you die. Shunt you. I need to shoot you. It's artillery. These blobs are going to be the death of me. I do need to punch that somehow. Yeah, I can punch it from where I am. Bring artillery to that spot. Well, that's what I shoot that one into that. I went into a building, but I don't want to do that. I'm just gonna punch you. Blob's done. Wait, if I artillery that spot, no, then Blob's gonna kill a building or a bomb. We can't let it kill a bomb. Bonus objectives rather than protecting buildings. You know, I might not be doing this quite the right way. Let's make more targets for them to attack, not near the bombs or stay near the bombs. I think they need one near the bombs. It's probably for my 18% to be useful, but it won't be. Power loss, 66 damages. And power loss, 96 damage. Yeah, we're kind of failing on master objective. These are bonuses, I need to remember that. Alright, what have we got happening? Too much stuff. The artillery is threatening me. Toilet's threatening me. Artillery, they're threatening building. Right, if I move, then that artillery and this hornet is not a threat. If the Fist of Doom moves, Carl moves out of the way. Lauren certainly shunt that firefly out of the way. Oh, it's a. Oh, it's giving you a bonus. Get rid of all the bonuses by punching that one out of the way. Which would be nice. It's gonna make it easy to kill them, but I don't need to kill them so much as I just need to. Oh, I can artillery that one into the other. Seems like a good move to me. So they'll hurt each other. Because this attack is one, but you know, every helps, every little helps. I can then shoot that one out of the way. He'll be down to one damage if I punch this one out of the way. Wait. Oh. That's attacking the building. I thought it was attacking me. You're attacking me. Well, I can punch it to protect the building, and I kind of need to protect the buildings now. Yeah, I didn't think that through. Or I miscalculated or something. Oh, that's nice. That's also nice. Alright, last turn. Please attack me, not the bombs. Or the buildings. Well, some of them listen. That can be destroyed by artillery, pushing that one harmlessly out of the way. That's a good move. You're no threat. That's a threat. That's a threat. Right, let's start with that move then. Oh, that'll push the bomb. Be careful, I do not want to push that bomb. Will do extra damage to the other one. That's a threat. That's a threat. That's a threat. Three threats. Three moves. Do not push the bombs. Artillery that scrub safely. Kill it, or moving into the path of that to kill it, either way works. Probably better just to kill it outright. Shoot that with cannon, punch that one. Won't kill it, but we'll. Let's start with that move. Bang. Right. I have two more threats to neutralize. And a punch, which won't kill anything, but will kind of neutralize its attack. Right, three neutral pointless attacks. Really squandered this extra power I got, didn't I? Well, I got two reputation and a core and a time pod, so it's not bad. Both prototypes survived intact. I can order Renfield and his team to move on to stage two. Two rep from the bombs, one core from the robotics lab, something from the time pod, hopefully good. Extra XP, Aerely has leveled up. Finally. What is in the time pod? One more core, so we've got two cores, we have two upgrades. But two upgrades before we have a Scorpion leader to defeat. And scorpions are bad. Lots of smoke though. Some water. We can maybe push it into the water post haste. Hopefully. It's probably massive, so it just won't die in the water, but just can't attack. But keep it in the water now. It'll be fairly harmless. Two cores. You can upgrade your cannons to do 2 damage, but not but lose the phase ability. What's the phase field? It applies a shield to buildings it passes through. That's quite interesting. Alternatively, you can get extra health and move. Or extra damage. Phase cannon that does 2 damage is attractive. Probably more so than the shield. We can use 3 cores for your damage, but not sure that's the right move. No, you must have been upgraded before. Leveled up earlier. After installing cores, I cannot move. Don't need both weapons right now, right? Just that or that. Two ways to do 2 damage is quite valuable. Alternatively, one long distance way to do 3 damage but lose my health bonus. If we can keep the baddie in the water, which we probably can't. Keep them in the water. The sand is not useful until we attack us, but I think I'm going to go with the. I'm telling you, I'm often firing just to shunt things, so let's do damage. Or shield buildings. All buildings are passes through, presumably. It's an interesting idea because if you're at the back there, you could easily protect everything quite regularly. Just sit at the back and shoot through the buildings. But I'm going to take the damage, so it'll actually mean we can. Taking extra damage, it means we'll destroy things quicker, which is more useful, and we'll get more XP, level up sooner. I think that's better. Well, we don't lose power if we don't. It means we can let a single attack happen on a shield, right? It'll destroy the shield, but it gives us more flexibility to choose who we're attacking each turn. But I expect the boss is going to be attacking a number of places every move, so let's do extra damage. Extra damage, let's do it. Right, so the Scorpion Leader has 7 hit points. It can walk in water but can't shoot. Yeah, immune to water. Webs. All targets around it prone to deal massive damage to adjacent tiles. 2 damage, webs everything. Dear oh dear. And we've got an Alpha Hornet off the bat, which is 2 damage to 2 tiles in front of it. And we've got an Ordinary Hornet. But we have nothing new arriving yet, right? What's his movement? 3 movement. I could start in the water and encourage him to come into the water, right? That'll be interesting. That'll give me plenty of movement options. Try that. Dad, look, the mechs, they sent mechs. So his attack does 2 damage, and his attack does 3 damage, so they both need to die. Kind of make them attack each other. I'm gonna shunt it. Which will make it attack that one and kill it, right? It attacks first, so that saves us one attack. Well, I shunt it or punch it. Punch it. Deal damage by firing to that spot. I'm just gonna kill that one. Dealing damage to it is never gonna be a bad idea. Deal damage to you, make you attack the water, and push you onto a spot where you'll take extra damage. I like that. And yeah, that looks nice. Those two will die, and that's down already down to only 4. I like that. Let's see what happens. Oh, the alpha bobber. You know, anyway. Great. Get health back. Oh, the scion came out. Kill it. The alpha bulb has not attacked. I shoot that and do 3 damage and 1 to that. I think that's what I'm doing. Let's see. Let's figure this out first. You only need to take 2 damage right away. Artillery you, then that frees up the web. So far so good. This pushes that one out of the way. We're gonna punch that first, takes 3 damage, and that'll take 1. Let's go. Oh, I can't attack from smoke, right? Yeah, let's undo that move. I'm gonna actually damage the building. I wanna move it. Artillery. The blob. We should move that, but that's because I'm webbed. And the blob's webbed, which is nice. And it's gonna damage the blob. But I don't want it to destroy 2 points of building damage. It's just too much. I can't get to a position where I can punch it this turn. In fact, I can't get to a position to punch anything this turn. That's not good. Unless I artillery that itself, which means I can punch it. Yeah, let's artillery a free our friend. Blob's in smoke and can't attack, so hopefully it can't even launch its other blob. And... oh, one, two, three. Why can't I get there? Where's my movement only three? I thought it was four. I can't attack from water. Alright, I guess I'll shoot you, stop you attacking the building, and then I punch the blob into you. And you'll kill the blob next turn. Thank you. Alright, what are we happening? What's happening? Scorpion leader's on one hit point. Did they just die if I kill that right away? It's an interesting idea. What's artillery useful for? Shunting, but shunting's not going to do us much good. We can absolutely kill the Scorpion leader with artillery. And... kill Scorpion leader with any of them, but the artillery is the weakest. Does this have any effect on death? No, it doesn't have any effect on death. I think killing it right now and neutralizing the other two attacks is the right move this turn. Gone. That's more XP for, Lauren, who is now halfway towards the level up. And that's one bonus objective done. Question is, can I... punch that into the cloud where it doesn't attack. Or shoot into the cloud, for that matter. Let's do more damage with the weaker one. Oh, they both do two. I forgot. No attacks. Let's see what happens. What have we got? Hornets and... that's a fine, and a firefly. Okay. They're all bunched up, which could be good. And this is the last turn. So, two buildings under attack. And three moves. That's not a bad combination. Unfortunately, we can't artillery it itself, but we can shoot next to it to knock it into ourselves. or we can shoot it with this gun. Or we can try killing him. Artillery that one shunts him into that, causing one damage to each of them, but then he's not dead. I need to do it from there, or I can go there. That one needs to die. That one I don't care. That one I don't really care. What's that one's attack? Oh, it's attacking that one. Well, I need to kill it or block its attack. I only just one, so I can tank it if I want to. If that's useful. I want to see if killing that is going to kill the ones on one hit point right now. So I'm going to allow the artillery to hurt itself. Why not? I thought I had a... How did I bonus? Oh dear. All my upgrades are gone. I want my face cannon, but... the extra hit points I had. Well, we'll have to find out what... how that happened. Yes, okay, so that does kill the ones that were only barely surviving. They're not moved, so I can cause one hit point to that and one to that if I artillery it. Now I can come in the way and actually punch. Ooh, undo that move. I can punch it into the other one and kill them both. Perfect. 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 Kill them all. Nothing was damaged. All of that kill. Did you see that? I must admit that was an impressive performance. We will rest easier knowing that Vec monstrosity no longer infests our island. One rep for destroying the Scorpion leader, one rep for protecting the tower, all 1,000 civilians protected. You completed every mission on RST despite the odds. You've earned my respect for Stalkers and everything we can offer. Perfect island. Select one free reward. What do I mean by perfect? Did I not lose any of the actual bonus objectives? I guess not. Grappling hook for cannon. Pull a mech towards object or unit to the mech. A free move. Presumably only pulls them one. That's weird. But pulling is sometimes insanely useful. Instead of pushing. Beth and Jones, mech starts every mission with a shield with an extra move and a different pilot. So swap out, say, my punching pilot who currently has lots of experience. Or grid power, two grid power. Two grid power is immensely valuable. I can buy stuff with my XP and not have to spend two of it on power. But how else do I go grappling hook? Well, presumably this stuff comes up in the shop as well. What does weight do? Alright. So what's happening that... oh, I must have clicked off the health accidentally. That was bad. Power, we need power, is what we're trying to say, but it's our global hit points. If we lose power, we're dead, so I'm taking the power. Right now, Kairi's, like, is basically as level up as can be. Early still has another level up to do. And Lauren also has one more level up to do, and both of them are about halfway there. Oh no, Early is a quarter of the way there. Early does more damage now, so I should get XP quicker. Let's spend my 7 reputation! I can sell the flamethrower back for 1, I bought it for 2. But It's not quite what I thought it was. Let's see what we can get. Teleporter, science class. We don't have a science mech, so we can't use bio teleporter. Repulse, also a science class weapon. We do not have a science class mech yet. Push all adjacent tiles. Repair drop. Heal all player units, including disabled mechs. Free power, any class weapon. Sail, but how do you... A one use per battle. Ooh, that actually could be good. That gives us lots of options. Passive effect. Mechs heal one damage when they deal a killing blow. But it takes power. That's very tempting. I'm gonna donate my flamethrower, because I do that and I'm gonna find an enemy that's like especially vulnerable to fire or something next island. But right now I'd rather just have the extra rep. I can get two cores. And I think that's the right move, because cores are insanely useful. Max upgrade, even if the pilots don't. If we donate him if I get one more core, but it seems I'd want a pilot, not just an AI-controlled mech, because the pilot gets XP and gets better. And he's right now gives us bonus grid defense, which is great. And he's got bonus HP, so special ability is no good, but you know, that's fine. I've got one more rep. I can keep it, or I can spend it on extra grid defense. So maximum plus 25 grid defense. I think it's difference between 18% to 20% right now. If I get rid of Kyle, I'll need to do that. But right now, I think I'll just leave it on 18%. If I get power bonuses, it'll go up anyway, so I don't need to spend my rep on that. I can keep my rep. For the next island. Oh. No, I can't keep my rep for the next island because it's a different corporation. Well then let's do that. Sure. Permanently upgraded. Well, except for the plus 3 from the pilot. And we've unlocked Pinnacle Robotics. After securing two corporate missions, the final mission is available to complete. The difficulty of this battle scales to your current progress. Fighting now will be as much of a challenge as attempting it after securing additional islands. Securing more islands before the final mission will allow you to save more civilians and increase your final score. So that's final mission. That's Pinnacle Robotics. And that's cool, but I will leave that decision for next time, and right now I am going to stop here. So nobody was watching, but thanks for watching if you did, and if you watch this on YouTube, thanks for watching there, and I will continue this tomorrow.